Welcome back, Tigers. We're going to learn how to send a DocuSign envelope to hundreds or thousands of people at a time. Our use case is we need to send an addendum to all of our customers to get an acknowledgement of our 2025 customer service changes. It would take forever to send these one by one to each customer. So let's go check out how to send bulk documents to our customers without writing any custom code. All right, here we are in our DocuSign demo account, and we're going to be working with this template called 2025 Customer Service Update. Now let's review a couple of things that we have going on. We are going to pre-populate data in this template. The full name is going to come from a contact. The tier here is going to come from an account record. And then we have our signature tags down here, but we have something special going on with our title. We want the contact to be able to update the title, and whatever they update the title with, we want that to write back into Salesforce. So we have configured a document custom field here that will have that configuration, and here's all the settings that you'll need to set up if you have a requirement like that. Now, in order for DocuSign to know which account and contact record to pull data from and or update data from, we're going to have to create a couple of fields here and drop those on the template. We're going to create an account ID field. This will just be a text field, and the font color is going to be white. We will save that, and then we will drop that on our document. And then we're going to create another one called contact ID. This will also be a text field. The font will also be white. And then we'll drop that on our document as well. And then you'll save and close this, and then your template should be all set. Now we're going to come over to Salesforce and we're going to go into Setup. We're going to go to Object Manager. We'll go to the DocuSign Recipient Status object. We're going to create a new field. This is going to be a text field, and it will be called DocuSign Recipient ID. We're going to add some help text here so we know why we created this field. So this field is going to be used as a helper field in the DocuSign Connect settings that we're going to set up for a bulk send. We don't have to add this to the layout, but you can if you want to. It helps when you're troubleshooting and testing. And then we're going to create a second text field. This is envelope ID. And this is also another helper field that we're going to use in the bulk send configuration settings. Next, we're going to go into DocuSign. We'll go to the admin tab, and then we're going to scroll down to our Connect settings. You should have a setting here for Salesforce, and we're going to go edit this. We will scroll down here, and then we can see these are the current Connect objects that we have. You may or may not have any here, but we need to add a new object, and this is going to be a Salesforce object. The object name is DocuSign Status for Bulk Send. And then we're going to select the DocuSign Status object here. It'd be so nice if this was in alphabetical order, wouldn't it? We're going to add if no match. And then in these settings right here, we're going to select the envelope ID is going to equal our DocuSign envelope ID. And then we need to configure all of these update fields down here. So I'm going to do those really fast. I'm going to do our recipient secure field, which is our account ID. And this is going to map to our account record here. Okay, those are all the fields that you're going to need, and then you'll just click save down here. Then we'll scroll down, just make sure that this is active. And now we're going to do this for another object. We'll click new object, Salesforce object. Let's just save here. It says that I have some changes that aren't saved. Oh, I activated it and I needed to save it. All right, so we'll come back in here. We'll go to edit, new object, Salesforce object. This is going to be the DocuSign recipient status for bulk send. We will add if no match, and this is going to be the DocuSign recipient status object. All right, here we're looking for the recipient ID is going to equal our DocuSign recipient ID. And then we're going to map our recipient secure fields for our account ID and our contact ID. And now we'll go through and add all of those field merges again, jam out to some tunes while I do this. All right, we've got everything saved here. And we'll come up here and we'll activate this object and we'll click save at the top. So now the beautiful part about the bulk send is that unless you have a new object like a contract ID or any other object ID that you're writing data back and forth between, you won't need to make any modifications to these DocuSign Connect objects. They will just work. Now we have to do one more Connect object for the contact object. And this is because we are writing the contact title back to the contact record in Salesforce. So this will be called contact for bulk send. This will be the contact object. And then we want it to find the contact record that is in the contact ID. And that's going to match contact ID here. And then we're just going to update the title. So you need to make sure that the field contact title has that label on your document, and we can verify that so you can see what that looks like. All right, so I will click save here. We will activate this, click save. Now let's go look at our template and let's go check out the contact title. So you come over here and the data label right here needs to say contact title. Same for our account ID and our contact ID. Those data labels need to match the exact value that you're putting in the DocuSign Connect settings when you're choosing a recipient secure field. All right, we'll save and close that. And then we're ready for our flow. We're going to hop back over to Salesforce and we're going to go to flows. We're going to create a new flow. This is a record triggered flow. This is on the DocuSign recipient status. And this is going to be a before save flow. So it's going to be a fast field update here. And then we're just going to do a get records. Make sure this is only going to fire when the record is created too. So we're going to get the DocuSign status record. So this is going to look for the DocuSign status record that has the same envelope ID that's on the DocuSign recipient status record. This will make it so that they get updated correctly in the DocuSign Connect settings. And then we're going to do an assignment here. And we're just going to update the DocuSign status. Correct. And that's going to equal our record ID that we found in the get records. And this is just this record ID. All right. So we are ready to save this. We will activate that. Now our flow is all done. Now we are ready to prepare our CSV file. So we're going to go over to DocuSign. We're going to go to our template. We'll click Use, go to Advanced Edit, click Bulk Send, click Sample CSV, and this is going to drop an Excel file onto your computer, and it will have just the headers in it. This template is what you're going to populate with the data for each of the people that you want to send this template to. So each row in this Excel file is going to be one recipient of this document. So now we need to go to Salesforce and pull a report that has all of the contacts that we want to send this to and populate this template and then upload it into DocuSign. So I'll come back over to Salesforce and I have a report here. I'm going to export this report. Oh, one thing I want to tell you. Now, in DocuSign, in the Connect settings, whenever you're mapping record IDs, it reads the 15-digit ID. So just be aware of that. You need to use the 15-digit ID unless you create a case-safe ID on the object that you're mapping. When we use the Connect settings over here, let me go ahead and show you. This ID over here in DocuSign is always the 15-digit ID. Now, if you want to use the 18-digit, then you'll need to create a formula field on the object that you're using. In this case, it would be the contact object, and you would just create a case-safe ID formula field that would bring over the 18-digit ID. So we have the 15-digit in our report, so we are all set for that. So we'll come over here and we will export our report. All right, here is our data. And now all we need to do is copy and paste the headers from here over to our data over here. So here's my name and my email. That's my SLA, my title, my account ID, and then my contact ID. And then I'm not using account name, so I can take that out. And then this is going to be my file. I will go ahead and save this. All right, and now we are ready to upload this file into DocuSign. We'll go to the template, we'll go to Use, we'll click Advanced Edit, click Bulk Send, upload a CSV, click Next. We will select our file. And then it will upload it and it will show you how it's going to map the data. So you can spot check it and make sure that everything looks okay. If there's somebody in the list that you don't want to send to, you can remove them from this list. We'll go ahead and click Save. And now we can customize the email subject, the email message. And if everything looks okay, we are ready to hit send. You can also schedule this to be sent later if you wanted to. We're just going to go ahead and click Send Now. Next is going to take you to the actual document. If you needed to make any changes there, we don't. We'll just click Send Now. All right, we can see our bulk send is now done. Now let's go check out our DocuSign status tab in Salesforce. I'm going to go to All. And then here's the records that we just sent out, all of these that were sent out at 8:33. We can see that they're related to the account. They're not related to the contact, so we need to check our mappings in our DocuSign Connect settings. Let's go ahead and open up one of these records. I have configured the DocuSign status layout to be a little bit more user-friendly so we can see all the data in one section. I don't like having to click on the related tab, so you can do that as well. That's why my page might look different than yours. And so our DocuSign status record got created perfectly from our bulk send. We can see our DocuSign recipient status also got created perfectly. Now let's go ahead and go to our Connect settings. I'm going to go to the DocuSign status for bulk send, and I'm just going to add the contact. This will be recipient secure field. This is called contact ID, and this is going to map to the contact lookup field. Save there. Okay, then this should be all set. Now we're gonna sign this and see if everything gets updated correctly because we need to test that title update. So let's go back to Salesforce. I'll go to my contacts. The contact that I'm going to test signing with is Michael Jackson. So Michael Jackson doesn't currently have a title. So I'm gonna go ahead and complete this DocuSign. Sign there, and then I will say, I am the king of pop. And then we'll finish. All right, so now we should see the title get updated. All right, it did, perfect. Okay, and now we can see our DocuSign status record is now related to our contact, which is perfect. So we'll click into that record. And we can see our account and contact. We can see our DocuSign recipient status and our bulk send is working perfectly. That's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next video we are working on that will show you how to send DocuSign from a custom object. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.